Welcome back to the Growing Band Director Podcast. This is episode number 181. We're going to be featuring the music of Count Basie for Young Jazz Band. That's grades 1 and grade 2.5 and anything in between there. The famous Count Basie quote that I love, if you play a tune and people don't tap their feet to it, don't play that tune again. So Count Basie's band was all about swing. So when we're teaching swing, thinking about the concepts of the rhythm section, there was four giants in the rhythm section who created how we teach swing jazz today. Philly Joe Jones was the drummer. What he did is he took the quarter notes from the bass player and put it in the ride cymbal, and then took the hi-hat and put it on 2 and 4. And he was the one to create that in the late 20s, early 30s. Count Basie, of course, we're going to talk about him at the end. Walter Page then would take that quarter note pulse in the ride cymbal and play it as a walking bass line to outline the harmonies, accenting slightly 2 and 4, which lined up with that hi-hat. Freddie Green was known so much for the quarter note, short quarter note style on the upper strings that matched the bass and the ride cymbal. Only in this case, it was a short quarter note rather than a longer quarter note. And they set the groove for the entire band. Count Basie then was free to do what he wanted to do. He didn't have to play because the harmony and the rhythm and the time were all there. So he was known for playing less many times. They created the swing concept as we know it, and it's essential to understand their creation in order to be able to teach the current swing style.
We will get right back to our content, but I wanted to thank you for being such an amazing band director, that you're taking your time and listening to a band director podcast. There's many options out there, and I appreciate you very much taking in this content. I hope that you understand that your students are very lucky to have you as their band director, that you're continuing to grow, and that they are going to benefit from your improved skills as a band director. You can share this episode with any band director friends or other music education friends who can learn from this content, because good pedagogy is good pedagogy. And if you could take a moment and go to thegrowingbanddirector.com, and you'll be able to sign up on our Patreon platform to give at least $5 or $3 a month. And it helps the content continue to be created for you to help our profession grow. Let's go back to our scheduled episode.
So those four people, Walter Page, Freddie Green, Count Basie, Philly Joe Jones, made up this whole rhythm section style the way that we use it now. And looking forward to sharing 9 charts with you from their canon. First tune is Topsy. It kind of has a Guy Noir kind of sound. This is arranged by a great writer, Rick Stitzel. This is a 1937 tune by Edgar Battle and Billy Durham. It was a hit for Count Basie in 1937 and for the Benny Goodman Orchestra in 1938. Durham, who was an underrated composer, had an association with Count Basie dating back to the Blue Devils and Benny Moten's band in Kansas City, and he was a pioneer of the electric guitar. This arrangement of Topsy, I hope you enjoy it. Big shout out to Tom Lazat for helping me with program notes on all of these tunes. Next, we're going to talk about a great chart, Jumping at the Woodside, right, written by the great writer Rich DeRosa. This Rhythm Changes tune is from 1938 and one of the most important recordings from the Basie Old Testament, which means pre-World War II band. It's credited to Basie, but most jazz historians say it was composed, at least in part, by Eddie Durham. The Woodside was a hotel in Harlem that catered to jazz musicians. The solos, great study material for young improvisers, are by alto Earl Warren, trumpeter Buck Clayton, and tenor Lester Young. And this is a great chart working on the swing style. Here is Jumping at the Woodside. That chart is probably in my top five of charts of this grade level of all time. Love it so much. The next one we're going to listen to is also in that realm for me. This is an arrangement by Michael Sweeney of the great Basin Street City Blues. Sorry, Basin Street Blues. This is a song often performed by Dixieland jazz bands, written by Spencer Williams in 1928 and recorded that year by the great Louis Armstrong. The verse with the lyric, "Won't you come along with me to the Mississippi," was later added by Glenn Miller and Jack Teagarden. The Basin Street of the title refers to the main street of Storyville, the red light district of the early 1920s New Orleans, north of the French Quarter. It became a red light district in 1897. Basin Street Blues was also recorded by the Count Basie Orchestra, of course. Amazing teaching tool for teaching medium slow swing, and all of the articulations used in jazz and the concept of laying back behind the beat are found in this chart. The solo section is a great vehicle for improvisation. So enjoy the Michael Sweeney arrangement of Basin Street Blues. Mention that all the charts we're listening to, because they're of this grade level, do have very good written solos out. If you want to utilize those, they're written in all of the parts typically for each section. You'll also notice that there will be flute parts, usually many times vibe parts as well, very well notated rhythm section parts. The next chart is Blues in Haas Flat. This is a great tune that's been arranged again by Rick Stitzel. Original Blues in Haas Flat is in D flat, and thankfully this is written in E flat for us, simplified a little bit. This is also known as Blues in Frankie's Flat. The band members were not excited that it was originally in D flat from the way the story is told. A 1957 tune by Basie's tenor player Frank Foster, a great example of the work of Basie's New Testament style, lots of dynamic contrast and a little more angular style of melodic writing. There's so much great stuff in here. Again, there's a trumpet solo in this and a little shout chorus at the end. Enjoy.
Thank you.
The next chart we're going to listen to is one of the greatest pieces in the jazz canon. This is from the Kansas City era back in the late 20s. This is called Moton Swing. The original Moton Swing is such a fantastic tune in A flat. This one is in a different key and much more playable. I've done this with my band as well. Hold on, let me check that. Is it in a different key? I should probably know. Hold on. Yep, sure enough, I was wrong. It is in A flat still, but it's written so well for a young band. I did this once with our second jazz band. It really can be done very well at the grade 1.5 level. It just swings out the door and you can teach so many great concepts. This is one of the more important pieces in the jazz canon. As I said, it dates back to Kansas City to the late 1920s. It was originally titled Moton Stomp. In those Jelly Morton days, many bands played what they called stomps. Swing, as we know it, was a few years away, and the tune was originally recorded by the Moton Band in an epic 1932 recording, this time as Moton Swing. When Benny Miller died of a botched tonsillectomy, Basie took over the band, and in 1957, he recorded Moton Swing as an iconic Ernie Wilkins arrangement. So here is the Mike Sweeney version of Moton Swing. The next chart, this is a tune called Splanky, written by the great Neil Hefti, and this is arranged by Roy Philippe. This is another New Testament Basie piece written by Neil Hefti, best known for his Lil Darlin'. If you don't know Lil Darlin', that's not on here, but that's a great, probably the standard slow swing ballad. This is a medium tempo blues that was recorded by 1957 on the Atomic Basie album by Count Basie. And that album, Atomic Basie, if you don't know it, is one of his most famous. So check out this lovely melody. Here is Splanky, Neil Hefti, arranged by Roy Philippe. Thank you. One thing we haven't really talked about is most of these charts are also available. You can use with less instrumentation, you know, as little as three saxophones and two trumpets and one trombone. They work really, really well. Great writer is Paul Murtha. If you haven't played Paul Murtha stuff, he's a fantastic writer for concert band as well as for jazz band. This is his arrangement of All of Me, one of the most classic Count Basie tunes. This 1931 tune by Gerald Marx and Seymour Simmons has been covered by artists as diverse as Billie Holiday and Willie Nelson. Frank Sinatra first recorded it in 1948. Its key association with the Basie band came in one of the best Basie albums ever, The Sinatra at the Sands in 1966. Quincy Jones wrote the original chart. This is such a great chart. You know, this is available as a vocal chart as well. In this case, it is purely instrumental. Enjoy All of Me, arranged by Paul Murtha. We have two charts for you left. This is April in Paris. This is the arrangement of it by Michael Sweeney, also known as the theme song, the unofficial theme song of the Count Basie band. This Vernon Duke Yip Harburg composition was written in 1932 for the modestly successful Broadway show Walk a Little Faster. The tune was inspired when the composers were at a restaurant and somebody at the table started talking about Paris. Basie recorded it in 1956 in a Wild Bill Davidson arrangement. The iconic trumpet solo with the Pop Goes the Weasel quote to start was by Thad Jones. This piece was also noted for its one more time exhortation by Basie to the band. Later, that plus one more once was said many times. So again, here's his sort of encore tune arranged by Michael Sweeney. Here is April in Paris. Thank you. If you have not checked out episode number 151 and 150, that was with Michael Sweeney. We talked about some of his concert band music, but a lot of his jazz band music too. He's really a fantastic writer for taking classic band jazz band music and putting it in an accessible way for young students, less experienced students. So I urge you to go check those out if you have not already. Our last tune is a tune that was new to me in researching for this episode, so I'm glad to include it. This is a tune arranged by Roy Philippe, written by Neil Hefti, called Coral Reef. This is in the Red series for Alfred Jazz. That means it's for first-year jazz, usually second- and third-year players. Trumpet composer Neil Hefti made many fine contributions to jazz, including his work for Woody Herman and Count Basie, as well as the Batman television series. Interesting. This piece is an attractive up-tempo riff tune that was recorded by Hefti's band in 1953. So the melody is a great little melody, again, scored for less instruments. Hope you enjoy it a lot. Here is Coral Reef, arranged by Roy Philippe. Sincerely appreciate you taking your valuable time and listening to the Growing Band Director podcast. Your students are very lucky to have a band director like you. If you have any suggestions for episode topics or think you have an area of expertise to share on a show with us, please reach out. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to help spread the word, please give us a 5-star review and tell your band director friends to subscribe as well. We're available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, our YouTube channel, and wherever you listen to podcasts. Thanks for listening to the Growing Band Director. See you next week.